And speaking of liking it raw, our guest is in the building. Man, what a guest we have today, man.
Special guest in the motherfucking building.
Englewood's own. A basketball legend. A NBA champion. A goddamn college legend.
Yep.
Somebody who's touched greatness on all platforms, on every possible layer that you can do it. This man has done it on. And he is here with us today to do what we do best, which is talk shit. Ladies and gentlemen, please make some noise for Mr. Paul Pierce.
What up, what up, what up?
Double P, my brother, my friend.
You didn't start it off with Hall of Fame, though. You know, you always got to put that.
Why didn't I get the AKA? I got AKA.
You got AKA? I'll set you up. Don't step in the AKA bucket if you're not going to finish it. If it falls flat, it sounds stupid. Nah. So do you have one to end on?
I mean, come on.
All right, here we go.
The man said he wanted
that. All right, you ready? Ladies and gentlemen, I got Paul Pierce in the building, AKA.
The Truth.
AKA.
That nigga.
AKA.
The Top 75.
AKA.
Hall of Fame.
AKA.
Englewood's Finest.
AKA.
I mean, come on.
That's right. He has some.
That's
right.
That's
right. He has some.
Top 75 on your ass.
You ain't never been top 75 in nothing.
Right, man. Today I'm a little embarrassed because they released my fucking high school highlights on SportsCenter.
Lying.
No, they all on social media killing me. Boy, when I tell you I didn't know I looked that bad, do you hear me?
Running around and shit.
Yeah, this is not going to be a conversation attached to Kevin and basketball at all. It is all thrown to you, Paul. Welcome to the show, man.
Hey, but you was nice in them celebrity games. I ain't going to lie.
It's a different story from basketball high school, brother.
You was balling.
In high school, it wasn't the same. I got older and I got better. Not as a young kid.
Right.
Life after basketball, man. How are you? Are you happy? Are you feeling good? Are you doing good? Where are you at now?
Yeah, I've been good, man. I've been getting the chance to really spend a lot of time with my kids, being a fan of the game and just enjoying life, man.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I've been traveling. Like I said, enjoying life, enjoying my retirement.
How old are the kids now?
Kids 14, 11, 9, and 1.5.
Wow.
You miss playing?
No, I don't miss playing.
No?
No. No, you know, my body say one thing. I like watching. You know, when your body get up and you try to go ball and you like, oh no, I ain't got this.
Yeah.
I ain't got this.
No more rec runs, no more loose runs.
It's still rec runs though.
You know what? I am gonna start rec run probably next week.
Okay.
You know, I've been working out the last couple of weeks consistent, so I think I'm gonna get back out there.
Yeah, you don't want to get that bad body basketball fall off.
No.
Right?
No.
Like, you know, them NBA players, boy, when they stop, it go backwards.
No, for real.
Yeah, you don't want that. You don't want that at all, Paul. You got to fight that.
You know, I do. You know, I got to say something to my boy. He got to get back in the gym, Antoine Walker.
We seen him last week, man.
And that's my boy.
Yeah, we seen
but
him.
He really got it. He got to get back in the gym. And,
belly
you know,
hanging
just,
out the bottom
that's
of his shirt.
That's just what I'm saying. But that's just not only – it's for health reasons also,
mm-hmm.
you know,
right,
so,
right.
you know, I want to see him doing better.
We were just with him, what, 2 weeks ago in Chicago. Yeah. He came to the show with us.
Well, the key thing here is Paul said that's his boy, which means that he can say that.
Right.
Yeah. He was at my house last week.
Yeah. So. I look Antoine in the eye and act like I didn't see anything.
The eye's still the same size. I'm looking at the eyes.
I looked at Antoine, gave him a hug. Good to see you, brother. What the fuck we going on? I didn't address it. I didn't say anything about it. There's no reason for me to say a word.
You was probably thinking what I'm thinking. Listen, that's all.
Paul, that's none of your goddamn business.
Did you tell him?
Yeah, I told him. Yeah. Come on, man. Yeah. Let's go.
Well, he need to, for real. Like, all joking aside, he does need to.
He came to the club with us. He took the whole section. He took that one side. He took that whole section.
The nigga daughter was in the club. He was hiding.
That's so sick. Come on, Twine. I'm going to get you back, baby.
Paul, when you say your brother, and you talk about Twine, of course, there's a lot of love that you have for a lot of the guys that you were on that court with. What is your rapport now with some that you play with? Are you guys still close? Do you still have those relationships intact?
Yeah, for sure. I still talk to a lot of guys. Tony Allen come stay with me. He actually gonna come stay with me this week. Kendrick Shout Perkins, you. KG. You know, I still talk to Eddie House, Rondo,
Ray Allen.
Yeah, me and Ray Allen talk on occasions. But you understand, you know, we grow and we got our kids and we got our family lives, but you know, we got a group chat.
Yeah, okay.
And so we
what's the name of the group chat?
Some guys not in it. Some guys are.
Okay.
I got a few group chats though.
The real ones.
I want to know what's the name of the group
everybody
chat with
but
you?
Everybody but
Ray. Dang. Everybody. No, KG let him back in the group.
That's
he let him back in the group.
Everybody but Ray.
KG let him back in the group.
Not even fast as fuck.
Everybody but Ray.
Everybody but Ray.
Everybody but
that's
three.
That's the name of it.
I gotta throw a couple more questions at you before we get into sports, and we're gonna let you just interact with us and vibe with us throughout. You know, joking around, of course, we're talking about the Ray Allen situation. The world doesn't know, of course, there was a little bump in that road just about the way Ray left. I want to talk to you guys about the world of champion, right? And when you talk about the way you guys did it when you did it, you were the first. Mm-hmm. You were the first to collab. In that manner, right?
Right
when
right.
you talk about you, KG, Rondo, Ray Allen, I mean, just the assembly of what the Boston Celtics were at that point in time and when you guys got the championship, to see teams follow suit mm-hmm. and do what you guys did, is there a sense of, like, you know, entitlement there as we were first or we didn't do it in the manner that you guys did?
No, yeah, I think it's like we didn't do it in that manner how they do it now today.
Okay.
Like, we did it through trades, you know, like more in a business aspect of it. And we kind of got lucky. You know, we got some picks. We was like, oh, okay, we could use this to leverage to get Ray Allen. Okay, we got some assets now. Let's see if they want to trade for KG. Now you become a free agent. You be like, look, all right, I'm going to go play with my boy over here.
I'm going to take less money.
I think we can build something and win the championship. So how we formed it, it kind of came organically, kind of, you know, through the business of basketball.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas now it's like you can kind of choose your path. And I'm not mad at the way they do it because, you know, guys are taking control of their own future and their mm-hmm. own legacy. And it's good to see sometimes, you know, but it just takes away from, in my opinion, the competitiveness of the game of basketball when you got current stars all playing with each other.
You talking about KD?
Well, yeah, of course. I'm talking about KD. I talk about even when LeBron went to Miami with Wade and Bosh. And so, and now you're seeing it with Kyrie, KD, and there. Now they're going here and there and forming these super teams. It doesn't always work out, but, you know, it works out when you got guys at that level.
I want to open up the floor to the guys.
I got a quick random thought that I just randomly thought about it. Because you're talking about free agency and shit.
You said random thought that you randomly thought about.
With, remember the Lakers made the trade a few years ago to get Anthony Davis.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But I felt like he was going to come to the Lakers next year anyway. And if they held on to those players, they'd be a much better team right now. Do you think he still would have came without that trade?
I think he was destined to come to L.A. You got to understand his agent was Rich Paul at the time, mm-hmm. who's LeBron's agent. They've been formed a relationship. And they already kind of talked their way out of New Orleans. So if they had held him for another year, he was definitely coming to L.A. So
They still could have had
them young pieces and still could have been winning today. Mm-hmm. You know, now they got a lot of older guys and, you know, the future ain't as bright.